this video, we're going to take a closer look at advanced graphing of motion. Let's start with an example problem. A bicycle rider starts from rest and travels on a smooth road. Here are the four stages of the bike rider's journey. From 0 to 3 seconds, a constant velocity of positive 4 meters per second. From 3 to 5 seconds, staying still. From 5 to 9 seconds, a constant velocity of positive 2 meters per second. From 9 to 12 seconds, a negative velocity of 3 meters per second. Given the displacement versus time graphs shown here, how would you represent the rider's journey on the graph? Using these axes, let's draw in each of the four stages of this journey on the graph. Remember that the velocity is defined as the change in displacement divided by the change in time. For the interval from 0 to 3 seconds, our velocity is positive 4 meters per second. If we begin at the origin, then after 3 seconds, we have moved 3 seconds times 4 meters per second, or 12 meters. So let's draw a line connecting those points. Next, from 3 to 5 seconds, we stop moving. On the graph, that means our displacement doesn't change over time. So for that time interval, we draw a horizontal line. From 5 to 9 seconds, our velocity of 2 meters per second means we travel 4 seconds times 2 meters per second, or 8 meters. Adding positive 8 meters to our current displacement means we end up with 20 meters from the origin after 9 seconds have passed overall. Finally, we move with a negative velocity from 9 seconds until 12 seconds elapsed. A negative velocity means the slope of the line for this segment of the journey is negative. The cyclist has turned around and is headed back to the start point. On the graph, a negative 3 meters per second curve from 9 to 12 seconds looks like this. We've now drawn each leg of the cyclist's journey on the displacement versus time graph. Now let's look at another example. You hop into a go-kart, and before driving off, strap a sensor on the cart that records your position every 1/10 of a second. After finishing your ride, the sensor displays the collected data that looks like this. In this curve, we can mark out 7 distinct regions with dotted lines and Roman numerals. What we want to know is, for each of the 7 regions, which ones show positive velocity, negative velocity, zero velocity, positive acceleration, negative acceleration, and zero acceleration. Let's begin with region 1. Our displacement versus time data curves upward. This means that not only is velocity positive, because the slope at each point is positive, but there is also positive acceleration, since the slope increases over time. In region 2, the slope of the line is still positive, but it stays the same. This means the go-kart is no longer accelerating, but it does have a positive velocity. In region 3, the slope of the displacement versus time graph is 0. That means the cart is not moving. Its acceleration and velocity are both 0. In region 4, the slope is positive and increasing. That means both velocity and acceleration are positive. The go-kart is speeding up in the positive direction. In region 5, the slope is positive but decreasing. So velocity is positive, but acceleration is negative. The go-kart is slowing down in the positive direction. In region 6, the slope is negative and constant. The go-kart's velocity is negative and its acceleration is 0. It is moving at a constant velocity in the negative direction. And in region 7, the slope is negative and increasing. This means the velocity is negative, but acceleration is positive. The cart is coming to a stop, slowing down in the negative direction. In the last example, a go-kart traveled in a loop while its displacement over time was recorded. For each of the points marked on the graph, the time and displacement are given in the table shown. Using this data and the graph, draw a velocity versus time graph, and acceleration versus time graph for the go-kart. Take a minute, press pause, and try it for yourself. Did you draw graphs that look like this? If not, let's go over how we created these graphs. First, let's recall a couple definitions. Velocity is defined as the change in displacement divided by the change in time. Acceleration is defined as the change in velocity divided by change in time. Since velocity is more closely related to displacement than acceleration is, we'll start there. We can use the data in the table along with the graph to calculate the velocity of the go-kart in each of the seven regions. In the first region, the slope is positive and also increasing. That means the velocity over region 1 is positive and increasing. To figure out the go-kart's final velocity in this region, we can look ahead to region 2, where the go-kart's velocity is constant. That value is equal to the displacement at point 3 minus the displacement at point 2 divided by the change in time between point 3 and point 2. Plugging in the numbers from our table, 85 meters minus 40 meters divided by 9 seconds minus 4 seconds equals 9 meters per second. This is the go-kart's velocity in region 2, as well as at the end of region 1. Now we can draw the first two parts of our velocity versus time graph. The go-kart's velocity starts at 0, increases to 9 meters per second in region 1, and stays at the same velocity in region 2. Looking back at the displacement graph in region 3, we see that the go-kart's displacement doesn't change. When we calculate the kart's velocity during this time, we find it equals 85 meters minus 85 meters divided by 13 seconds minus 9 seconds, which equals 0 meters per second. We can now draw in the velocity in region 3, a flat line at 0 meters per second. In region 4, the slope of the curve is positive and increasing, which means the velocity is also positive and increasing there. But what is the go-kart's final velocity in this region? Unlike last time, we don't have a region with constant velocity coming next. The velocity in region 5 is not constant either. What we can do is place a tangent line on top of point number 5 like this. Then we pick two points on the tangent line and use the grid to figure out their x and y coordinates. This allows us to find instantaneous velocity at point 5. Here we pick the points that turn out to be at 14 seconds and 70 meters and 19 seconds and 190 meters. We can use the definition of velocity to solve for the cart's velocity at point 5. That velocity equals 190 meters minus 70 meters divided by 19 seconds minus 14 seconds, which equals 24 meters per second. If the go-kart leaves region 4 moving at 24 meters per second, what is the velocity in region 5? We see from the displacement versus time graph that once more, the slope of the line in this region is not constant. This time the slope is positive, but decreasing. As we examine the final slope of the line in region 5, it appears the slope at that point is flat, neither increasing nor decreasing. This tells us that the velocity of the go-kart at point 6 is 0 meters per second, having slowed down from going 24 meters per second at point 5. We draw that in on the velocity versus time graph like this. Moving on to region 6, we see that in this region the slope of the displacement versus time curve is negative and constant, which means that the velocity is negative and constant. The go-kart is traveling at a constant rate back toward the origin. The value of the velocity in this region equals 20 meters minus 145 meters divided by 31 seconds minus 20 seconds, which gives us negative 11.4 meters per second. Finally, in region 7, the slope is negative and increasing, which means the velocity is negative and increasing. It begins at negative 11.4 meters per second and reaches zero by the time the ride ends. We draw that line in, and now have our completed velocity versus time curve for the go-kart. Now we can begin on the acceleration versus time chart. We know that the acceleration is defined as an object's change in velocity divided by its change in time. Looking at the first region of the velocity versus time graph, we see the go-kart's velocity goes from 0 meters per second to 9 meters per second in 4 seconds. Plugging these values into the equation, we find that the go-kart's acceleration in region 1 rounds to 2 meters per second squared. The go-kart is speeding up in the positive direction. In region 2, the change in velocity is 0, which means the acceleration is 0 as well. In region 3, the change in velocity is 0 again, so acceleration remains 0. In region 4, the velocity goes from 0 meters per second to 24 meters per second in 3 seconds. Plugging those numbers into the equation for acceleration, we find that the go-kart's acceleration in region 4 is 8 meters per second squared. The go-kart is once again speeding up in the positive direction. In region 5, the velocity drops from 24 meters per second to 0 meters per second in 4 seconds. This means the acceleration in this region equals negative 6 meters per second squared. The go-kart is slowing down in the positive direction. In region 6, the velocity of the cart does not change, so acceleration here is 0. Finally, in region 7, the velocity goes from negative 11.4 meters per second to 0 meters per second in 8 seconds. Plugging these numbers in, the acceleration in region 7 rounds to 1 meter per second squared. The go-kart is slowing down in the negative direction. That's a closer look at advanced graphing motion. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.